Welcome to Wager Talk TV, everyone. Minty Betts here as your host, joined by Dave Kokin. Give him a follow on Twitter at Dave Kokin and Ralph Michaels at CalSportsLV on Twitter. Give them both a follow, please. This Sunday afternoon, we've got a nice NFC West matchup between the Rams hosting the Seahawks. I'm seeing Rams favored by 1.5, 2 points, and the total set at a high 55.5 points. Dave, what do you think about this game?
I had the Bills as my best bet on Sunday against Seattle, and it was an easy win. And part of the reason I played it was twofold. One was that the Bills figured to throw the ball on a Seattle defense that is putting together an historically bad season against the pass. They are on pace to blow away the all-time record for most yards allowed per game through the year. But that's all everybody's talking about now, is the fact that they can't stop the pass. Bettors have a tendency to, and not just bettors, just fans have a tendency to remember only the last thing they saw. And the last thing they saw was Seattle getting absolutely torched by the Bills all afternoon. But again, that was a bad spot. They were coming out of a big game in the division against San Francisco, and they had this game against the Rams on deck. That was not a good scheduling situation for Seattle. And that's the primary reason I played the Bills. I thought, boy, this is worth a point or two because Seattle doesn't figure to be at their sharpest here. And what happened? Well, they were bad defensively, as always. And Russell Wilson had, by his standards, a really bad game. They put some points up, and Wilson had 4 turnovers and wasn't sharp. I think you'll see a return to more typical Russell Wilson form here. And I also think that now you've seen a line adjustment. And again, it's based more on last week than anything else. If you turn back the clock a couple of weeks, I think you can make an argument that games pick them. Now the Rams are 1.5 or 2. So you're paying an immediate price for recency in terms of the Rams or the Seahawks, as the case may be. And I generally don't like to do that. I'm not going to lock myself into a play on this game yet because I haven't done all my NFL handicapping. But just based on line value, I would have to look at the Seattle side here.
Ooh, I like that. And Ralph, what do you think about this one?
You know, it's funny, Dave. This is what's great about these videos. I think there's line value on the Rams. And why do I think that? Well, we know an offensive number. We know what a defensive rank is. But I'm a big guy in yards per play and yards per game diff. And you look at the Rams are number one in the NFL, plus 104.5 yards per game. Seattle is number 27th at minus 40.8 points per game. You know, you did talk about their passing yards on defense. Just to give you perspective, Seattle is allowing 362 yards per game. The next closest team, the 31st team in the league, is 310 yards per game. Now, just because Seattle has a bad pass defense doesn't mean Jared Goff is going to be able to exploit it. You know, he's back to that 13-6 ratio after having a good start. And that's without getting sacked. The interesting thing is I think the Rams will be able to get some pressure. You know, you have the D-line. You added A'shaun Robinson this week. He just came off the list. He'll be eligible to play. And you look at Russell Wilson. He got sacked 4 times against Minnesota in that 1-point win in a game he didn't get covered. He got sacked 5 times at Buffalo in a game they lost they didn't cover. Every other game he got sacked less than that, and they did win the game. So I actually am leaning the Rams in this game. They're coming off the bye. They have several players that were on the injury list that's coming back. And you have Seattle in a difficult stretch at Arizona, home San Fran, at Buffalo, at the Rams, back-to-back road games on the East and the West Coast, 3rd road game in 4 weeks against a team off a bye, and that was embarrassed in the bye the week prior against Miami. So my lean to the Rams, who won't make my card, but a clear check mark if I had to choose a winner in the game.
Okay, Dave, do you have anything to add to that before we leave? Any thoughts on the total?
I'll make a little counterpoint. I think some of the Rams' numbers are phony because they have already played the entire NFC East and they won all 4 games, and that's like having four free wins. Seattle still has to play 3 of those 4 teams. They played Dallas, and that was Dallas with Dak Prescott. They won that game 38-31. They have yet to play Philadelphia. They have yet to play the Giants. They have yet to play Washington. Those are games that Seattle figures to put up fabulous numbers in. So I don't like the Rams as much as their record indicates, as much as some of their stats indicate, because of the four cupcakes on their schedule. I think Seattle's done their work against a much tougher schedule. So there's my argument
to
that.
Dave,
but again, it's not on my card either.
I'm going to add one more point to your counter against me, which is backing your point. And I'm not afraid to give a stat and then say, well, this stat is semi-diluted because of, against Miami, a game they lost, they had a 326-yard edge, which clearly skews all your numbers for the season. So they wouldn't be number one in yards per game without the Miami plus 326 yards. And can you really count a team plus 300 yards if you lost the game? You know, Miami couldn't gain any yards because they kept scoring defensive touchdowns and special teams touchdowns, leaving the Rams offense on the field. So that is a point which lessens the strength of my number one in the NFL in yards per game diff.
And real quick thing. Everybody gets hung up sometimes on there was a ton of money on the Arizona Cardinals, and they were a real popular play last week against the Dolphins. And everybody kept saying the same thing. Well, the Dolphins just lost. They just won a game where they got outgained by like a million yards. They got lucky. Sometimes that's not such a bad thing. And Miami just went out and had another game where they got outgained again. They're 2-0 in those games. Sometimes efficiency outweighs the actual stats. Miami's been pretty efficient the last 2 weeks. Be careful about overweighing, putting too much value on stats that sometimes might lead you in the wrong direction.
Good point.
Good stuff. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Guys, for $1.99, get every college football and NFL play for any handicapper through the end of November at sportsmemo.com and wagertalk.com. Thank you, guys.